NotAgetOnline.com/LiveWire.
Now, joining us in studio, multiple award winner.
Oh.
Very beautiful, very sexy, very talented, and just adorable this morning. It is adult superstar, Kristina Rose. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm excellent.
You told me off air you're trying to wake up.
Yes, I am. Actually, I think I sent your friend to get me coffee. That's why they're not here.
No, it wasn't him I was looking for.
Oh.
No, not him. Yay. Q never showed up, Greg. No. Yeah. We did it. We did sports.
We did sports.
We really did it. We just didn't know what to do.
Way to be on it, though, to get him.
Yeah, I'm running in the back.
Yeah, well, Scott does it every day.
Yeah.
Scott does it every day.
Oh, keep it up. Now, Kristina, I was reading about you before you came in, because I always do like to do, you know, a little research. I need to ask you, though, what nationality are you? Can I take a guess?
Okay.
I'm going to get it wrong, though, aren't I? You have that look like you know.
I know. Yeah, I know. You're probably going to say one thing.
Right. I'm going to say you are. This is so hard.
Half and half?
Is it just two things?
Well, what are you asking me if my mother was involved in a gangbang?
No,
who my father is?
No, like was your mom one nationality and your dad another?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm going to say you are, I'm going to get this wrong, I know it. I'm going to say you are Korean and white.
No.
No? What are you?
I'm Mexican and white.
Mexican? Really? You get Asian a lot, though, don't you?
I smoke a lot of weed.
Yeah. Now, where did you grow up? Where did you grow up? Where was home?
Southern California.
Of course it was.
Born and raised. OC, LA, San Diego.
Yeah. And so you were 23 years old before you even started doing anything, right?
Yep. In porn, yeah.
Yeah, working for a photographer, and they said you should model.
Of course.
Am I right?
Basically, yes.
And then from there, you went on to really do a ton of movies.
Yep.
Win some AVN awards.
Yep.
Now, the first time you're nominated for an AVN, is it one of those things where you're like, wow, that's cool? Or like, oh my God, everybody knows who I am now.
Well, the first time I was nominated for an AVN, I was like, it was about time. Because they snubbed me the year before. And so I was like, yeah, that's right.
I love it.
Finally, you guys, you've been sleeping on me for a minute.
Right. You got it now. But were you like, were you overwhelmed? Were you happy? Were you freaked? Like, how does that work?
I was super psyched just because AVN, to me, the most important thing is getting nominated.
Mm-hmm.
Getting nominated, because getting recognized, there's thousands of people in the industry and scenes shot every day. So getting recognized alone is the win.
Yeah.
And then, you know, all the fun stuff that comes with it. It's just cool to be nominated and recognized out of all those people.
Now, are you pretty, are you still making movies? Are you working a lot now or are you slowing down?
Well, I slowed down after that whole Mr. Marcus situation.
Yeah.
I stopped doing Boy Girl.
What happened there? Can you talk about it?
We can do a brief little.
Yeah, explain to the listeners who don't really understand the situation. What went down? Keep in mind we're on terrestrial radio.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll try to keep it.
Yeah.
PG.
Right.
Basically, what happened was Mr. Marcus had contracted syphilis.
Right.
And instead of just taking care of it and everything, he went and took care of it, but it wasn't really taken care of properly. So he had the virus and hid it and worked on a test that he doctored.
Yeah.
And he put everyone in the industry at risk.
A huge risk.
And it was just a really sad situation because Mr. Marcus has been in the industry for so long. I mean, he's like technically, he was going to be the black Ron Jeremy, basically.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And a lot of people in the industry trusted him, you know. And
yeah, he had a good reputation up until then.
And he just dutied all over us, basically.
Right, yeah. No, I know what you mean.
Instead of just being like, look, I can't afford not to work for the amount of time it's going to take for me to recover from this and ask someone for help, financial help, he chose to doctor his test and put us all at risk and basically shut the industry down. And
yeah, and I have a feeling had he gone to some of the bigger contract companies, they would have helped them, right?
You know, here's what it is. It's porn. A lot of people try to act like they make a lot of money or they're good with their money or whatever. They're not. Most people in porn are not. They're out there throwing their money around. Okay, we're all people. People just live and they do their thing. If you financially are in an effed situation, you need to know when to put your pride aside and just ask someone for
somebody
help.
Somebody help me, please. Yeah.
Seriously.
It's not like he was strung out on heroin.
Thank you.
You know what I mean?
You know, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we've all gone into work with a cold or two.
Yeah, but this is syphilis, Joe DeVito.
Yeah, syphilis is a little different.
Killed Al Capone, for Christ's sake. They ain't messing around. I'm not messing with something that killed Al Capone. The government couldn't even kill Al Capone.
If I can count all the times I've gone to work with syphilis.
I think you just did. Now, were you ever at risk?
There is a window of possibility. Like, I worked in a... This is another very porno situation.
Yeah.
I worked in an orgy scene where...
He was involved in.
He was involved, but the director couldn't afford to have me and the other girl that's with my agent to work with all of the guys. So we were only allowed to work with two of the guys. Mr. Marcus is notorious for being, like, 2-3 hours late.
Right.
So he didn't get first dibs on the best asses in the movie. So
right.
I didn't get work with him, but there... During that time, that could have been when he had first contracted it.
Yeah.
I don't feel okay with that. There's a lot of male performers new to the game because of, all the Viagra and guys are shooting up their dick.
Yeah. Whoa. Can't say that. That's okay.
My bad.
That's right. No, but guys are shooting up their equipment and just to be able to perform.
With what?
Dude.
What is it?
That Caverjack.
Yeah, it's like instant erection. It's
really?
Like the only way
what,
I know
like
how to put
like
it.
For like all day or something? Or
yeah, I think I'm not.
It's like Novocaine,
really,
isn't it? Really, it just numbs it so much.
It's used for, I believe it's used for people like paraplegics.
Right.
I don't really know exactly. I don't know they shoot in their dick and it makes it like.
It's the second time you can't say the D word.
You're lucky I'm not saying the F word.
No, I know I am. Thank you. Now listen, you're going to be at Fantasy's nightclub.
Yes, and I will be saying the D word.
That you can say it there all you want. In fact, you can wear a shirt with it on there.
I'm not going to wear a shirt.
Kristina, that's good. You'll be there tonight, tomorrow, and Saturday, 3 nights.
Yeah.
2 shows each night.
Yes.
It's going to be a great time. Go to fantasiesnightclub.com for all the details, and you can find Fantasies Nightclub on Facebook and Twitter. Live Nude Girls on Twitter, is that right? Now, Kristina, let me ask you another question. And Cal will tell you, I'm not just saying this. I'm always very nice. I'm always very nice to the adult performers. I think it's one of those, how do I word? I hate the hypocrisy that you guys have to live through, meaning every congressman, every senator, every freaking Bible-touting moron in this country watches your work. And then they enjoy it. And then they come on TV or on the radio or whatever, and they preach like you're the devil. And it makes me insane. And I think it's one of the most honest things a human can do. You're in charge of your sexuality. You're in charge of your body. When people say women are degraded, now, I didn't watch porn in the 50s and 60s when maybe they were. I don't know. But every scene I've ever seen in porn... It pretty much seems like the chick was willing to sleep with that guy. And not only that, the guy seemed pretty amazed that the girl was going to have sex with him.
They like, usually are.
Yeah. Like, if I was in a lineup of guys, right, and you were like, yeah, I'd work with him, I think it would take me 2 days to recover from you just saying yes. You know what I mean? Like, if you were like, yeah, you could put him on my hit list, I don't even know if I could do it. Joe, like if a porn star told you, yeah, let's make a movie together, you would need 6 months to recover just from the...
Well, first I'd have to check with SAG-AFTRA to make sure it was a union job.
Right.
My question is always, how is the craft services table?
Let me tell you about craft services in porn. You're lucky if you get a warm bottle of water and a bag of old Doritos or Sun Chips.
So pretty good.
So you're still way ahead of
comedians.
Yeah. We're probably only part of show business to get screwed more often than you do.
You guys got 7 a.m. crab cakes. I don't know about that.
You came, look.
I had to take mine out of the garbage, though.
Yeah, we had to wait for the summer solstice, if that gives you an idea. But do you find that... Do you find the hypocrisy annoying? Like, or do you just not care?
I think I used to find it annoying, and now I just find it as a easier way for me to quickly judge someone's character.
Right, right.
Basically, wow. You know, like, if that's how you are, I know how you are.
If they're preaching at you, you know immediately, like, this guy's a douche.
You're on the TV saying this and that, but right. You're emailing me asking me if you can buy me as an escort.
Yeah. Right, yeah. Now, do you work as an escort sometimes?
No, that's not my thing. I have friends that do it. I don't hate girls. That's their...
Yeah, what the hell?
It's just, I can't do that. I do what I want, not what someone pays me to do. That's why I like porn. Porn, the director is asking me if I'll do something for this, and I tell them how much it is and who I'll do it with.
Right. Now,
That's pretty... So it's like a la carte services then, right?
Yeah. Everything's a la carte in porn.
That's good.
Yeah. Every now and then you can go to a buffet, but those usually aren't that
good.
Well,
you have to pay the buffet like price, though.
Right. Yeah, you have to pay.
See? That's how they
get you. The all-inclusive?
The all-you-can-eat? There is an all-you-can-eat.
But usually the buffet's cheaper.
Yeah, but not in this case. Yeah, it's not the good
it's
stuff.
It's Fugo de Chao.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
There's some delicacies on the all-you-can-eat
menu. Yeah, I bet there is. Now, what is your, or do you have any restrictions? Now, I know we have to be careful. Like, are there things you go, nope, never doing it? Don't say the act, just yes or no.
Well, there's not really very many acts that I wouldn't try.
Right.
But, like, I've been asked if I would ever do, like, tranny or anything.
Like, be with a transsexual.
I'm not into, I don't want to do.
What about, like, fetish stuff?
I do some fetish stuff.
You do?
Yeah, I do a lot of stuff for kink.com.
Okay.
And they do a lot of really hardcore fetish stuff.
I'll give that the thumbs up.
Yeah. Let me ask you a question, though. One fetish I don't understand, and I'm wondering if you do. Mm. I don't understand the foot fetish, feet.
Oh, I know this. I didn't understand it at first either because I didn't realize I have perfect feet until
right.
I got into porn.
Yeah.
And at first I was kind of weirded out about it, but then I was like, they want to pay me to look at my feet and stuff. I'm with that.
Right.
So.
Yeah.
And I like it. Foot massages and stuff.
Yeah, like it doesn't bother you? I think it would freak me out. Like, I don't like feet.
Yeah.
But I don't like feet on my kids. I'm like, why can't you just have nubs and balance on them? Like, I don't like feet.
Yeah.
So I think it's weird to me. Like, that one's weird to me.
Probably because you're a guy, though. I'm a girl, so guys want to, like, worship my feet.
No. You don't understand. I've had gay men. And Greg
knows
this.
Come up on your feet?
Like, really write me letters and say, can I have a picture of your feet and stuff? And I'm like,
wait. I've had a couple on Facebook with that, too.
Yeah. I'm like, what?
Block.
Yeah,
block,
yeah.
Block.
Yeah, I was like, how much?
Yeah, you're like, I need the money.
Right, no, seriously, much. Just throw out a number and just get this PayPal.
Yeah, $1,000.
I mean, yeah,
I sell my panties. Yes, I do. Yeah.
Nobody's going to know they're your feet.
Now, what do you charge for panties?
I charge $150, and that includes shipping.
That includes
That's
shipping.
That's very nice of you.
How about handling?
Yeah. How much for... StudyItOnline.com.